Cells in our body have a membrane-enclosed structure called the nucleus, which contains all our chromosomes. And when a cell divides, it has to make sure to distribute it and partition all those chromosomes to its two daughter cells. And the key process in this event is the reformation of the nuclear membrane around all chromosomes. At very low frequency and at much higher frequency in cancer cells, there are certain mistakes that occur in the cell division, and individual chromosomes can literally lag behind the other ones. So they're not included in the main nucleus, but they rather acquire their own nuclear membrane and form what's called a micronucleus. And micronuclei have been known to pathologists for decades, and they have been considered to be a passive marker for genome instability. But more recent work from David Pellman's lab at Harvard actually suggests that the chromosomes inside those micronuclei fail to work properly. So they can no longer transcribe the genes, they can no longer replicate. And what's even more interesting, they can show that these micronuclei are the cause of a completely new phenomenon called chromotrypsis, which is the catastrophic fragmentation or pulverization of entire chromosomes. And interestingly, those pulverized and re-ligated chromosomes can be reincorporated into the nucleus of the next cell division and can manifest themselves in the next cells and have changed gene expression program and can thus directly contribute to tumorigenesis. And so what we found is a molecular explanation why those chromosomes in micronuclei fail to work properly. And the answer is in a catastrophic collapse of the nuclear membrane around those micronuclei.
When we identified nuclear envelope collapse as the cause of micronucleus disruption, we became really interested in why this was happening. And so that's when we began to look at the lamins, because we knew from our previous research that those are really important for maintaining the stability and structure of the nuclear envelope. And when we looked more closely at the lamina, what we found is that it's specifically in micronuclei, it's forming these holes. So normally the lamina is like this proteinaceous network that's underlying the membrane. And in the micronuclei, they form these large holes, and that's where we're seeing the membrane weaknesses, where you'd see like bulges in the membrane, kind of the chromatin bulging out. We were able to take videos of these holes forming in the lamina, and we found that a lot of them were appearing very, very soon after nuclear envelope formation, after mitosis, which suggests that this may be an early problem specific to micronuclei with nuclear envelope formation. And then this leads to the loss of all of the soluble proteins inside the micronucleus. And so what this means for the micronucleus is that all of the basic nuclear functions are also lost. So if we look at transcription or DNA replication or DNA damage repair or even the histone acetylation, all of these are lost in the disrupted micronuclei. And in addition, we also have evidence of massive DNA damage happening in a subset of these micronuclei that have undergone micronuclei disruption. Interestingly, after we see this disruption, the micronuclei don't just stay in this kind of nice, you know, circular chromatin. They actually undergo this, the chromatin becomes very compacted, and it also becomes penetrated by endoplasmic reticulum tubules. So the nuclear envelope and the endoplasmic reticulum are a continuous membrane system. And so we think in the primary nucleus that that membrane system is able to repair itself, but we see something different in the micronuclei, where we see instead of this membrane spreading into sheets, we see these tubules invading the chromatin, which is not something that we've seen before. This micronuclei disruption is happening in micronuclei in every cell type that we've looked at so far. So we've looked at cancer cell lines, we've looked at normal non-transformed cell lines, we've looked in patient tissue, and in every single case we find evidence of disrupted micronuclei. So what that means is that we can use disrupted micronuclei as a marker for the presence of micronuclei in general. Now we have a very easy way to identify micronuclei, genomic instability in solid tumors very quickly and very easily.